Morning students, I am Christopher Krizzel. Today we will be learning English language of class 3. We'll begin with the first chapter, that is chapter 1, the sentence. Okay, so when we speak or when we write, we use sentence or sentences. Now what is sentence? Suppose you take a look here, okay? I have written some words here. A, boy, I, good, am. Now when you read these words, does it make any sense? Do you understand anything by reading these words? No, you don't understand anything. So, a sentence is a group of words that makes complete sense. Now, when you arrange these words once again, now when you read these words, I am a good boy. Yes, it makes sense. You can understand something by reading this sentence, not the first one. Okay? So this is the definition of a sentence. A sentence is a group of words. This is a sentence. It is made of a group of words that makes complete sense. Another point to remember, a sentence always starts with a capital letter. If you look here, you can see it is starting with a capital letter and it ends with a full stop. Yes, if you don't put a full stop, that means the sentence is not completed. It is an incomplete sentence. Okay, so these are few things to remember. A sentence starts with a capital letter, it ends with a full stop. Now, there are some sentences that also end either with a question mark or with an exclamation mark. Okay? Now, for example, if you read this sentence, where do you live? Now this is a sentence, but in the same time it is also a question. It is asking you a question. So in these kind of sentences, we do not put a full stop. It becomes wrong. We will put a question mark. Is it clear? So sentences that ask you questions, they always end with a question mark. It will start once again with a capital letter but end with a question mark. Now there are some sentences that end with an exclamation mark. For example, if you read this sentence, how beautiful the rose is. Now this is a sentence, but in the same time it expresses feeling. Okay, so we will use an exclamation mark at the end of this sentence. Now sentences that end with an exclamation mark, point to remember, it expresses feeling. Where do we use exclamation mark? As I told you earlier, we use question mark when the sentence asks you a question. In the same way, we use an exclamation mark when you express feeling, a sudden feeling, feeling of joy, happiness, okay, maybe sadness, excitement. So sentences where feelings are shown, we use an exclamation mark at the end of such sentences. Is it clear? I hope you have understood these few examples that I gave you. Now, In your English language copy, you will start this chapter from a fresh page or new page. On top of the page, you will write chapter 1. At the side of it, the name of the chapter, that is the sentence, and underline the chapter number and the chapter name. Okay? After finishing this, from the next line or from the first line, you will start writing. Firstly, you will write the definition of a sentence. Okay? As I am writing it here on the board, the same sequence or the same pattern you will follow in your English language copy as well. Okay? So first, after writing the heading on top, you will write this, what I'm giving you, okay? The first question is, what is a sentence? Okay, put a question mark. Then below that, you will write the answer. A sentence is a group of words which makes complete sense. Okay, you will write this in your copy, the definition of a sentence. A sentence is a group of words which makes complete sense. Remember this point, okay? Group of words, complete sense. Is it clear? After writing this, you can write one example below it. Okay, you will write this, flying bird is a. One thing to remember, don't start with a capital letter and no full stop, question mark or exclamation mark. Now when you arrange these words, then only you will use a question, a capital, then only you will start it with a capital letter and end it with whichever punctuation marks, maybe a question mark or a full stop or an exclamation mark. Now when you arrange these words, what sentence will you get? Proper sentence. That is, a bird is flying. Now this is a statement, okay? A bird is flying. It is starting with a capital letter and it ends with a full stop. Okay? So this much you will write in your copy. After finishing this till here, from the next page, okay, I repeat it once again, after finishing this much, from the next page, you will write now some exercises, okay. Now these exercises that I am giving you is for your homework. I will do one number and the remaining you will do it yourself, okay. Now from the next page, you will start writing. This is the first exercise, okay? You will write the heading first on top. The heading is rearrange these words to make meaningful sentences. Okay, once again, underline the heading as I told you in my previous class also, of literature that always underline the heading. Okay, so this is your heading. Rearrange these words to make meaningful sentences. Okay, I will do the first one with you, and the remaining numbers you will do it yourself. Okay. Now when you write the question here, like the first one, you can see the shines sun the sky in. Now you see this, that I have not started this with a capital letter and neither I have used any punctuation mark. Punctuation mark means full stop, question mark or exclamation mark. Now when you arrange these words and make a proper sentence, that is the time when you will use capital letters or punctuation marks. Okay. Now I am doing the first one for you. Okay, now arrange these words. So what sentence will you get? The sun shines in the sky. End it with a full stop. Okay, so this is the sentence that we got. The sun shines in the sky. It is starting with a capital letter, ending with a full stop. Now there are total 5 numbers here. The first one I showed you, the remaining 4 you will do it yourself. Okay, I'm giving the questions here, you will write the answers yourself. Okay, this is the second question. Lights, Diwali is the of festival. Okay, the answer you'll do it yourself. Then question number 3. Question number 3 is Blas the broke who? Okay. And question number 4. Question number 4 is house your is where? And the last question, that is number 5. Water drank I from glass a. Okay, so this is the first exercise that you will do in your copy. After you complete this, then again in the next page you will do the second exercise that I am going to give you now. Okay, after the completion of this first exercise you'll do the second. Here's a look, I'm giving you few seconds just to see the question one time again. Okay.